Thanks for watching TechWiki. Click the subscribe button, then enable notifications with the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos. What exactly comes to your mind when you hear the words self-driving car? Do you picture a mostly normal vehicle that lets you let go of the wheel sometimes? Or do you think of more of a rolling living room without a steering wheel at all that's so advanced that you could curl up for a nap in the back seat? Well, as it turns out, there isn't really an official definition of what autonomous or self-driving means, even though vehicles with some self-driving features are already becoming widespread. So, the good people at the Society of Automotive Engineers, you know, the same folks that get a shout out on bottles of motor oil to tell you how syrupy it is, identified this problem and defined 6 levels of autonomous driving to classify a car's capabilities. But why exactly do these matter? Is this just an exercise in sorting things into meaningless categories, like the menu at Subway? Actually, perhaps not. The US government has adopted the SAE categories, which means that they could be used in the future for everything from deciding how tightly to regulate certain aspects of production and testing, to how to label cars for consumers, to determining insurance rates. After all, just because a car is self-driving doesn't mean it's immune to accidents. So let's look at the 6 levels as they're defined today, starting with 0. Which probably describes the car in your driveway right now. A 0 might have a proximity warning system on its backup camera to kind of beep at you if you're about to hit your boss's Lambo, but what's important here is that to stop still requires user intervention. Cars that fall into this level are incapable of driving themselves outside of old school cruise control. Next up is level 1. If your car can control itself to some degree, any degree, based on information it gathers about its surroundings, it belongs in this category. So features like lane assist, where your car can auto-steer if you're drifting out of your lane, or radar-based cruise control that automatically slows down and resumes your previous speed depending on what's ahead of you, these are hallmarks of level 1 vehicles. Level 2 denotes cars that can drive completely on their own in specific situations by both steering and handling acceleration instead of just one or the other. So if you have a more advanced autonomous cruise control system that can also nudge the car to the left or right, or you have a self-park feature that could squeeze your car into a tricky parallel spot, you've got a level 2 vehicle. But keep in mind that another characteristic of this level is that the driver always has to be attentive and ready to intervene. Level 3 is where things start to get really interesting. These cars are capable of driving down a normal road and along a specific path according to a destination punched in by the driver. Cool, right? Well, hold on. Level 3 cars don't have meaningful fail-safes, putting them in a weird sort of automobile limbo. Like, part of the point of automated driving is to increase safety and allow occupants to do other things during the trip. But level 3 cars are supposed to still have human drivers that can instantaneously take over if something goes wrong. Meaning, if your fully self-driving car encounters a situation it cannot resolve on its own while you're watching a movie, that may end up being your last Netflix binge ever. So it's not surprising then that many car companies are trying to jump straight to level 4. Like level 3, level 4 uses a human driver as a failsafe, but it is smart enough to handle certain trickier situations. This means that a level 4 car can be specifically designed to handle certain tasks fully or drive within a limited geographical area, while still requiring a human driver for situations that it isn't quite intelligent enough to deal with on its own, like a difficult merge onto a busy highway. The biggest difference is that if a level 4 car encounters a scenario outside of its limits, it has to be able to safely abort the drive, typically by parking the car until the human inside can take over. Currently, Google's self-driving Waymo fleet is comprised of level 4 vehicles, meaning that they can be operated without anyone inside, but they are restricted to certain locations. So currently they are geofenced inside the Phoenix area. Ford is aiming to make its own Level 4 car available commercially by 2021. Of course, though, the holy grail of truly hands-off driving is Level 5, a car that is always in complete control of itself with zero intervention from the driver ever necessary, or even possible. Many Level 5 concept cars don't even have steering wheels. A Level 5 car should be able to handle any condition that a human would, and theoretically, with more safety and precision. Although companies like Nvidia, Audi, and VW are currently working on Level 5 cars and the AI technology needed to power them, it isn't clear when they'll become a reality. Not only do they have to convince the public that a robot-controlled car, whatever, my dancing's not very good, won't get hacked or choose to drive them off a cliff to save a flock of geese crossing the road, there are significant hurdles with government regulations that need to be cleared. So until that day, be sure to drive carefully and let us know down in the comments if you'd like to see a future tech quickie on how the AI inside a self-driving car actually works. Synergy 2 is designed to be easier and more seamless to use than Synergy 1. Synergy is a mouse and keyboard sharing software that works on Windows, Mac, and Linux computers with features like Share from Anywhere, which automatically allows you to control any other computer without reconfiguring, SSL encryption to protect your keystrokes from attackers, dynamic networking, which detects the best route based on your network setup, and the ability to run always on in the background as a service on all operating systems so you can set and forget. If you get the Pro version, you can get access to other cool features like clipboard sharing, dragging and dropping files, copy and pasting, lock screen synchronization, and more. So check out Synergy 2 today at the link in the video description. So thanks for watching, guys. If you disliked, hit that button, but otherwise, hit like, check out our other channels, comment with a video suggestion, and subscribe!